Welcome to Camper Trailer of the Year 2021, brought to you by the power of Redarc. Today we're looking at the Bushwhacker Boma, a South African expedition-style trailer that impressed us quite a lot. DC, who do you reckon the Boma is targeting, and do you reckon it's hit the nail on the head?
The Boma is targeting those people who like to go out and set up somewhere and really enjoy a particular location. I can't think of a camper I would rather be in, camped at the back of a beach up on the Kimberley or up on the Cape or somewhere like that. There's just panoramic view from either of the beds. This uniquely set up camper that comes with a king on one side and a queen on the other side. You fold them out, you open those windows and there's panorama from inside there. It's just a fantastic camper. It hits the nail, bang.
So Glenn, it's one thing to be able to say it would be great to go and spend a week in the Kimberleys with it, but what sort of specs do we have from self-sufficiency and how many days do you reckon you'll get?
Tim, I think you'd certainly be able to get 2 weeks out of it. It's got the South African pedigree, so it's built strong and it's built tough. With the Duetta hot water service, got the two 100 amp lithium batteries with solar of 300 watts, got 110 litre water tank plus a 75 litre fridge. Catch your fish, draw your water from a water course, you'd be there for months.
Remarkable use of space. Every square centimetre has got a pocket hanging on, or it's a little cupboard, or it's another nook.
So Tim, while you're out there remotely, what keeps you comfortable?
DC's right, king queen bed, can't beat them, and they were super comfortable beds, like really comfortable beds. 120mm high density foam, I believe they were. Another little feature I really liked about it from a comfort point of view is the condensation ceilings above each of the bed. We know that when you're somewhere out back where it starts to get a bit cooler overnight, the chances are you're going to get a drip on the face, but not in the Boma. We saw the Boma last year at Camper Trailer of the Year, and it did exceptionally well there as well.
It's a camper that's really, truly unique. It looks just like a shoebox when it's towing along the road. Assemble this thing, it's just astonishing.
I think that's the thing with this. The looks are really deceiving. As you said, when you follow along behind a Boma, nothing much to see there, and they unfurl it like a jack-in-the-box. By the time you've finished, you've got something that's going to see you well in remote areas for as long as you need to be there.
That whole water system you mentioned from a self-sufficient point of view, 12 volt, really like that, with a 10 litre holding tank. Guys reckon it's about 28 minutes to heat the tank to 75 degrees, and then once you've got that, you can just turn the mixer and you should be able to run quite a number of showers. They said as many as 6 showers before the tank then is a bit cool. I really appreciate that, plus the twin bush fan 180 degree awnings. It's going to keep you really nice and covered on those stinking hot days in the Kimberley. One thing they've done this year is they've rearranged the kitchen slightly. So there's now permanent access, or all-time access, I should say, to the first aid kit, which I really do appreciate. And they've just changed the bench layout around, which has just kept it all close together and just made walking around the camper underneath those awnings a lot easier. I reckon it was one of the best rides of the competition, one of the best tows. And the mirrors that it had were fantastic. The inertia brakes were fine. And it's as simple as needed, but as tough as can be. So from a towing point of view, I think the Boma is going to be fine.
I like the number of things that you've got that are dual purpose.
DC, what are your thoughts on innovation on the Boma?
There's so many points of innovation in this camper. I mean, this huge awning that goes right around it. It gives you a huge footprint. It's 8 by 12 metres. So you're not going to fit this onto your average little caravan park site if you want to set all of that out. 500 kilos of load capacity. I was really impressed by the volume of storage. Everywhere you look, there's another cupboard.
I really like the fact that you've got a custom-made wood rack. You don't see that as often as you should.
Kath, what were your thoughts on value for money, and overall, what was your X factor?
So, I mean, in terms of value for money, at $55,000 for something that's this well-built, is this well thought out, I think you really can't go wrong with this. The South African credentials around this means it's tried and tested, great layout, and a really beautiful piece of kit. The level of quality combined with the really thoughtful use of space, really great layout. This is a hard one to go by for the rugged off-road, long-stay campers. So X Factor, well really, this is the sort of travel partner I like. It's rugged, it's capable, it's no nonsense, and you're likely to be enjoying its company for as long as you choose to be out in the great outdoors.